When nothing else could help. love lifted me. Your love lifted me. I am free to sing of your love, sing your love.
Thank you. I am free to sing of your love. praise Jesus for the wonderful new day. Thank you for this Sunday, Lord God. Thank you for all the people who are coming to church today, Lord Jesus. Thank you for those who are staying back home, whether out of sickness or for any other reason, Lord God. We're asking for a blessing on everyone, Lord Jesus, today. We're praying for Pastor John and Mama Olga, Lord God. Give them traveling mercies, Lord Jesus. Embrace the family that suffered a loss, Lord God. Embrace the Atachos family today, Lord Jesus. We're also praying for the praise and worship service today, Lord God. We're praying for the sermon today for Brother Dre as he's preaching today, Lord God. We are praying for our hearts to be open to you, Lord God. And as we always come on Sunday, we pray, Lord God, that it would not be just Sunday for us, Lord God, that it would be a continuation through Monday and Tuesday and Wednesday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday, Lord God. Every day, Lord God, you would touch our hearts and they would be open to you, to your word, to your spirit, to your love. Thank you for this Christmas season, Lord God. Thank you for this service, Lord Jesus, for touching us, Lord God, for loving us and taking care of us. We commit this service into your hands, Lord God, in the names of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Bless you.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Indeed, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Yes.
Are you happy to be in the house of God this morning?
Yes.
I want you to touch your neighbor and encourage them to say that God is good,
yes,
all the time. Let's say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good.
And your mercies endure it forever.
Yes.
I didn't hear you the first time. Lord, you are good.
Hallelujah. are, yes you are, yes you are. So good, so good. Yes you are, yes you are, yes you are.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you. I'm a glory. Jesus Christ, we do this because you have given us authority to declare a thing and it shall come to pass. And Lord, now Jesus, as one body in Christ, we join forces to declare the powers and the kingdoms of darkness shall fall right now in the name of Jesus Christ. And let your kingship, oh God, Father Jehovah, reign in Russia, reign in Argentina, and in all the nations of the world. Father, you are not a man that you should lie. If you have said, oh God, that we declare a thing, it shall come to pass. Therefore, as we have declared, so shall it be, oh God. I pray that righteousness shall reign in this nation, oh God. I pray, oh God, Father Jehovah, that sons and daughters of this nation shall rise up, oh God, to declare your name as our Lord and as our Savior. I pray a turnaround, oh God, for those who do not know you, that they will begin to seek your face, oh God. I pray an encounter with sons and daughters of this nation, that they will have an encounter with you, oh God, and they will recognize you and acknowledge you as God and Savior in their lives, oh God. Reign over this kingdom, oh God. Reign over these nations, oh God. Have your way. In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed. Amen.
Аллилуйя.
Мы стоим перед великим Богом.
We are standing before the presence of God.
Мы стоим перед лицом Творца всей вселенной.
We are standing before the face of Almighty God, the Creator of the universe.
Он великий Бог.
He is a great God.
Он знает твое сердце.
Your heart.
Богу не нужна причина, чтобы любить тебя.
He doesn't need a reason to love you.
Он любит тебя, потому что ты его творение.
He loves you because you are his creation.
Потому что ты его сын и ты его дочь.
Because you are his son and you are his daughter.
Он знает каждый уголочек твоего сердца.
He knows every corners of your heart.
Он знает твои победы и знает твои неудачи.
He knows your victories and your failures.
Он знает, что нужно исправить тебе в жизни.
He knows what he needs to fix in your life.
И я хочу сказать тебе что-то важное.
I want to tell you something very important.
Бог пришел не для того, чтобы уничтожить этот мир.
He didn't come to destroy this world.
Он пришел, чтобы дать тебе свою жизнь.
He came to give you your life.
И если бы он хотел каждый день бить тебя,
if he wanted to beat you every day,
он не был бы Богом.
He wouldn't be God.
Он хочет, чтобы ты принял его жизнь.
He wanted you to accept him into your heart.
Но есть какое-то очень важное условие.
But there is one very important condition.
Господь, Бог святой.
Our God is holy.
Святой.
Is holy.
И Слово Божье говорит, что без святости невозможно к Нему прийти.
And the Word of God says that without holiness it's impossible to see God.
Он сегодня, прежде чем ты сюда пришел, был здесь, Господь.
Before you came here today, he was already here.
Его не нужно звать, он сам бежит.
You didn't have to call him, he's already here.
Но чтобы ты мог коснуться,
so you could encounter him,
нужно что-то менять в своем сердце.
You have to change something in your heart.
Мы должны понимать, что 24 старца падают, закрывают лицо и говорят: «Свят Господь».
We have to understand that the 24 elders fall before God and cover their eyes and shouting, "Holy, holy, holy, the Lord God Almighty."
И это тот же Бог здесь.
That same God is here.
Он здесь.
He's here.
Для тебя.
For you.
Если есть что-то,
if there is something,
что мешает тебе,
that is disturbing you,
приблизиться к Нему,
to go towards God.
Он сейчас здесь для тебя.
God is here for you.
Не наказать тебя.
Not to punish you.
Он хочет, чтобы ты исправил.
He wants to fix something in your heart.
Он готов тебе помочь.
And he's ready to help you.
Он любит тебя.
He loves you.
Я хочу, чтобы ты сейчас закрыл глаза.
I want you to close your eyes right now.
И вернулся к тому месту, где Господь однажды тебя нашел.
And go back to that place where God once found you.
Тот самый первый день, когда Он сказал: «Я люблю тебя».
That very first day when He said, "I love you."
Вспомни, что Господь простил тебя.
Remember what God has forgiven you.
Вспомни, сколько изменилось с того момента.
You remember everything that changed at that time.
Посмотри, сколько Он тебе дал.
Just remember what, just look at what He has given you.
Он дал тебе все.
He gave you everything.
Потому что Он подарил тебе небо.
Because He has presented you heavens.
Он подарил тебе свою жизнь.
He gave you His life.
Свою.
His own life.
Божью.
His own godly life.
О, как Он тебя безмерно любит.
Oh, how He loves you unconditionally.
Безмерно.
Unconditionally.
Без причины.
Without any reason.
Просто любит.
Just He loves you.
Я прошу, чтобы ты открыл свое сердце.
And He comes here so that you could open up your heart.
Размышляя.
And just think about it.
И благодаря Господа.
And thank God.
За все, что Он тебе дал.
For everything He has given you.
Аллилуйя.
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 Forever,
Jesus, I need you.
Jesus. Thank you, O God, because you are God and there is no one like you. We thank you, O God, for your unfailing love. We thank you for your love and mercy that endures forevermore. We thank you, O God, because you are the God that came into this earth just to die for us and to have a relationship with us. We thank you, God, for your grace. We thank you for your everlasting grace and everlasting mercy. We thank you because you are the only God that is powerful enough to forgive us of all of our sins. And Lord, we thank you, God, for bringing us into your presence today. And we thank you, oh God, for loving us. Not because we loved you first, no. We thank you because you were the first to love us. And we thank you, oh God, for calling us your own, for calling us your sons and daughters. We thank you for your presence in our lives. And we thank you, oh God, for the peace of God that you've given each and every one of us. And Lord, as we worship you this morning, we pray that you accept all our thanksgiving, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And we thank you, oh God, because we know that you will always hear our cry for mercy. And you will never abandon us. You will never leave us nor forsake us, no matter what the devil might throw at us. And Lord, as we come into your presence this morning, we pray, oh God, that let your loving kindness never cease to be shown upon our lives in the name of Jesus. And Lord, I pray, oh God, that you keep increasing your presence in our lives, that you keep increasing your favor upon our lives, that we'll keep seeing how good you are in our lives, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for ICA. We thank you for every members of our church. Lord, today, oh God, as we come in your presence, we pray, oh God, and we rebuke every sickness, oh God, everything that is disturbing your people from worshiping you, and every members of our family that are sick right now, we pray in the name of Jesus that you touch them, that you remove every sickness, Lord, in the name of Jesus. May it be cough, may it be flu, whatever it is, oh God, I speak right now by the power that is in the name of Jesus, that they are healed today in the name of Jesus, that you lift them up, oh God. And those who are traveling, I pray for journey mercies. Those who are broke, I pray, oh God, that you give them money. Those who are in poverty, I pray that you send them help. Those who need grace, I pray that you give them grace. Those who need favor, I pray that you give them favor. Those who deserve mercy, I pray that you send mercy to them. Those who need you, oh God, to do miracles for them, I pray, oh God, because you are the God of miracle, that you send forth miracles right now in their lives in the name of Jesus. Those who are scared because of their exams, I speak peace upon them right now in the name of Jesus. Those who are worried because of their financial situation, I speak peace of God upon their lives right now in the name of Jesus. Those who are troubled because of what they might be going through, I speak peace right now upon them in the name of Jesus. I thank you because you are the Alpha and the Omega, and there is nothing impossible for you to do. You are the Almighty God, and your name is above every other names. And at the sound of the name of Jesus, we know that every knee has already bowed down to the glory of God the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost. In the name of Jesus Christ, we worship, and the church shouts a big amen. Hallelujah. 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 Good morning. Well, before you sit down, I would like you to just give some hugs, just a big hug to people around you. Hug them. Give them a big hug. It's cold outside. Tell them, I love you with the love of the Lord. It's so nice to see you. I've missed you. It's been in a week. It's been 1 week. I missed you so much. Go around, move around, hug somebody, greet someone. Don't be shy. Hallelujah. 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 Well, it's time for our tithe and our offering. And as I always say, you shouldn't come to the house of God empty-handed. And I know God has done a lot for you. And just your face can tell me that God has been good to you. Amen. Well, if you have your tithe and your offering today, I would love you to just dip in your pocket, raise it up, and we are going to pray for it. I want to encourage you to be a Christian who know how to give, who love giving. Don't be stingy with giving, with opening your heart for God and your hands for God. Yeah, I know you might be saying things are very hard. Yeah, I know things are always hard. But with God, we know all things are possible. Amen. Are you ready to give this morning? Hallelujah. Well, let's pray for our offering, our tithe. Jesus, we thank you, O God, because you are God that has given us everything. Lord, as we give back unto you out of what you've given unto us this morning, we pray that you bless our finance, oh God. We pray, oh God, that you increase, oh God, our accounts, Lord. Just help us, oh God, in this situation, we pray. Lord, those who are in really financial needs, we pray, oh God, that you send forth help to them in the name of Jesus. Bless us, oh God. Bless ICA. Bless Russia. And bless all the countries that we come from, Lord. We give you praise, glory, honor, and majesty. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Good morning, church. Thank you. Yes, let's start. For a miracle, the heart longs for a little bit of hope. Oh, come, oh, come, Emmanuel. The child prays for peace on earth, and she's calling out from a sea of hurt. Oh, come, Emmanuel. The sound of love, come down, come down, Emmanuel. He's a song for the suffering. He is Messiah, the Prince of Peace. Has come, he has come, Emmanuel.
Check. Good morning. How are you today? All right. Let's go before the Lord. Father, we just thank you so much for this morning. Thank you, Lord, for the fact that you're always with us. And thank you, Lord, for your desire to reveal yourself to every human being. Thank you, Lord, for the fact that you decided to humble yourself and come down on this earth and touch us and bridge that unreachable gap between the mankind and yourself. We thank you, Lord, because the Word has been made flesh and made His dwelling among us, and we have seen His glory. Father, we just want to ask you that you be with us today, that you prepare our hearts, you would open them up, Lord, and help us to receive the message that is from your Word. Help us to get a better grasp on what you were trying to say to us. Father, I just pray that you use me as a vessel today, and so that everything I say would be would come out as your Word. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen. Well, if you're a teenager, guys, you please be dismissed. Today is the last day for the rehearsal before for the Christmas play that you guys are doing. So if you in the youth group, so you guys are free to go. Now, before I start, I still have to make a quick announcement, actually two announcements. Number one is next Sunday we are celebrating Christmas, right? Yeah. So the ones who are excited about it are the ones who know what's happening every time we get together to celebrate, right? We have a great service usually with a service where we celebrate the Lord's coming, and we have a lot of food, right? So my question to you, or rather my appeal to you, that it's always a combined effort. The church will provide certain things, but if it's possible, if you're willing to do so, if you're able, would you please bring a either a traditional dish from your country, something that you would like to share with everybody else in the church. I know the Filipino ladies, you guys all do this amazing job. You know, you just throw up a feast every time we celebrate something.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Amen, sister. But if you are not able to cook, or, you know, you just can't bring a dish, you can at least go to KFC and bring a bucket of chicken, right? Yeah, we're going to do it family style one way or another, right? All right, thank you. Well, you guys, if you want to do something like that, would you kindly let us know, like, if you're planning on doing something? But, yeah, please do. Please bring something if you can. The next one is an exciting one as well. Now, this one goes out to, all right, how many people here are married? Okay. All right. How many people are in a relationship getting ready for marriage? I know some of you looking. All right. Some of you people looking at me like, Dre, it's a personal question. How many people are you single and looking for the partner? The reason why I'm asking this question is because we have a great... A great opportunity coming up. Now, I'm not saying that I'll get you a partner. I'm saying that we'll give you the resources on how to prepare yourself so that you'll be better in the relationship, whether you're already in the relationship or not. Mark your calendars, January 5th and January 6th, from 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. For those 2 days, we are going to have a special seminar. And we are having special guest speakers for that seminar. The title, you ready for the title? All right, for those of you who are ready. The title of it is Love Language in the Family. All right, so the only thing, it's free. The only thing we're asking you to do is we have sign-up sheets out by the door. So we need to know how many people are coming because we're going to provide refreshments. We're going to provide coffee, tea, and snacks and stuff. We are going to have a coffee break, maybe some sandwiches. So we need to know how many people we're shooting for, okay? So please do that. Thank you, sister. God bless you. All right. Now, anyways, I'm excited about it. And now we are going to, we're going to have the most important part of the service. Turn your Bibles to John chapter 1 with me, please. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. The Gospel of John, first chapter, and let's read together from the beginning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. This man came for a witness, to bear witness to the light, that all through him might believe. He was not that light, but he was sent to bear witness of that light. He was the true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld His glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. I'd like to focus on the 14th verse of this passage in particular. But I just want to give you a bigger picture. And well, it's obvious that we are in the Christmas season. Or let's say the holiday season, because not everybody is celebrating Christmas at this time of the year. If you're from Russia, most likely the most important holiday for your family is New Year's. We'll get there. Where families get together, exchange the gifts. To others, it's just the season of shopping and the Christmas discounts. Everything's 60% off. So everybody is kind of expecting something during this season, and everybody got different reasons, different understanding of what it's all about. To some people, it's just, oh, it's the end of this old year, and I'm about to start a new year, which means a new start. I'm going to make my New Year's resolutions, and I'm going to try to accomplish something different this year, right? So, for others, if you're in Russia, you're looking forward to the season because it's time of work, right? Where you get many days, well, some of you get many days off work, and you're just going to chill and rest and catch up on some sleep, right? Now, we as Christians, we believe that this is the season, this is the season where our Savior Jesus Christ was born. And that's why this month or this holiday is so special to us. What's amazing though, marketing and advertising is a powerful thing. Like there's a spiritual side of Christmas that we as Christians celebrate and we remember Christmas. But then also, there's a commercial side of Christmas that even in Russia, Christmas is becoming more and more Western or more Americanized. You go to Starbucks and you hear Christmas carols playing here. You're like, wow. Feels like you're back. Feels like, oh, I'm back in the States again. But, you know, okay, that's cool, you know, but not everybody actually think about the real meaning of it. What's interesting though, now hear me out and don't hear what I'm not trying to say like I usually like to say. A lot of people get too stuck on December 25th, on the special date of Christmas. My opinion, there are two holidays which every Christian should celebrate and remember, not, you know, on certain months or certain days, but every single day of his life. And those would be Christmas and Easter. Because Jesus, our Savior, came into the world, and this is basically the greatest event in human history. Easter is when Jesus died for our sins and he rose again so that we may have eternal life. Amen. And receive forgiveness of sins. Now, some scholars recently discovered that, well, I mean, it's not a recent discovery, actually. You know, even if you do some Bible study, you know, you'll probably prove that to be true, that Jesus was not born in December, neither he was on December 25th, neither was he born on January 7th. But actually, they put that date sometime around, like, end of September, maybe. There are different opinions. Nonetheless, whatever your opinion is, it's just an opinion, and it does not diminish the fact of the fundamental truth of the Bible, that Jesus came into the world. And this is what I want to focus on, because I don't know, it doesn't matter what people around us believe. It doesn't matter what the advertisements are, you know, how commercialized Christmas becomes. We need to remember that Jesus came into the world to die for the sinners so that we may have life. Amen. And so the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. What's interesting that sometimes, I don't know about you, but do you fully understand this passage? You know, when the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, the Word was God, or the Word became flesh. Well, I don't know about you, but to be honest, you know, being a 21st century person, to me it sounds really abstract. I don't really understand what it means. And what really helps sometimes is to look at the some historical facts and what people in those days believed about the Word. Because first and foremost, this Word was written for those who lived in the first century. And But when you read it in the first century, with that mindset, that was something important. And that was something great. And if we understand it, this will only enhance our understanding of God and the things of God. So, as you know, the New Testament was written in Aramaic and in Greek, right? So, the Word that is translated into English as Word has actually two Greek words. The first one, let me start with the second one, is the one that for those of us who come mostly from a lot of from charismatic and Pentecostal churches is Rhema. And a lot of people like studying this word, you know, what it means, where in the Bible it's being used. And but really, if you define it, it simply means a piece of information. Now, remember in Luke chapter 1, verse 38, don't have to go there, I'll just tell you real quick. When the angel appeared to Mary and he gave her the news that she would be pregnant with the baby from the Holy Spirit. And Mary said, "Behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your rhema." Or in other words, let it be done to me according to what you just said. The first meaning of of the word that we now translated as word is logos. This word is actually used in the book of 1 John chapter 1. In the beginning was the logos, and the logos was with God, and logos was God. And then we skip into chapter 14. The logos became fleshed and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory. Now, why is it important? Well, it is important because, okay, first and foremost, in the religious thoughts of those days, what's really amazing is that it doesn't matter what type of background you were from, whether you were Jewish, or you were of Greek background, or you were of a Persian or Babylonian background, the idea behind the word logos, or word, was very identical, which is so amazing. Now, I'm not trying to say that they were equal in their beliefs. No, they were totally different, but this one thing, it was something that they understood pretty much equally. Now, to the Jews, the word basically equal to God. And then if you know from Psalm 138, verse 2, it says that, you know, let me just read it. I will worship toward your holy temple and I praise your name for your loving kindness and your truth. For you have magnified your word above your name. In the midst of, in those societies where there were different kings, people who did not really value their word, you know, here comes a heavenly ruler who never breaks his word, who lets you down. When he says something, he puts his word so highly above his own name, and that whatever he does, that's what's going to happen, and he's not going to change his mind. Amen. Now, for the Greeks, because as you know, Israel was occupied by the Romans, and that entire part of the world was influenced by Greek philosophies and things of that nature. This way it gets really interesting. Logos was not just a spoken word. It was not something I say to you. It was the word that is not even spoken yet. Something that's still in your mind, your reason. So Greek philosophers implied the rational principle that governs the universe by using this word. So in other words, if I am the Apostle John and I'm writing these words to the people of those days, I'm telling them, listen, the reason, the universal reason is becoming the flesh. None of those mythical gods that you are talking about, but the very reason that created the universe and holds everything together is becoming the flesh. So whether you are Jewish or the Greek background, it means the same thing. That somebody who is divine, somebody who is not of this world, somebody who has the ultimate power, somebody who is greater than all of this, becomes flesh and makes his dwelling among us. Amen. Isn't it profound? So, the Egyptians and Babylonians and the Persians and Romans, they had similar concepts. And we don't have time to go into that because we are talking about the Bible, which is the Word of God. But if you really look at this passage from this perspective, so I would call that, using today's Christian language, the universal proclamation of the gospel. So that it doesn't matter what part of the world you're coming from, when you read this passage in those days, it means that God is coming to us and is bringing something different to us. What's interesting is that, since we were talking about the reason of God, in Luke chapter 4, verse 32, it says that when Jesus taught people were amazed at his teaching because of his logos and authority. Of course, the English says word and authority. So it's not only the things that he was saying, like pieces of information, like giving you like some, okay, I don't know, maybe it's not very accurate, but not those rhema type of words, but he's given the very reason and the very mind of God to the people. And that's why people were amazed. Because those were not human words. Those are the words that came straight from God. And so, God himself puts on human flesh and comes. So the next thing that I wanted to point out to you guys is that it says that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. If you stop for a second and think about it also, so that God, who is the creator of the universe, who is sovereign, who is all-powerful, who is all-knowing, who is present everywhere at the same time, who's uncontainable, who's too holy to even deal with anything that's sinful, he comes into the world that is sinful. And again, to some people, even today, when you begin to talk about it in this day and age, they look at it like, how can somebody so holy and so great come to a sinful world? We don't deserve that. To others, it's just absurd. To some, it doesn't fit into their little understanding of the world and to their spiritual, into their spirituality. That God enters the world as a man. You know, what's interesting is that in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 23, right? Remember we said that to the Jews, the message of the cross and the message of, we can also talk about the fact that Jesus is coming and then he's coming with a purpose to die for the world. And then to the Jews, it's a stumbling block. But to the Greeks, it's foolishness. Because, that doesn't fit into their understanding. In fact, one of the predominant Greek philosophies in those days, and you can find people believing the same things today, is that there was a spiritual world and it was good. And then there was a material world, which is evil. And the spirit cannot touch the material world. It's beneath it. That's why it's foolishness to them. But to us, these are the words of great comfort and great power, because the Almighty God, the creator of the universe, decides to become like me so that he can relate to me, so he can address my issues, and so he can work within my circumstances and make a difference in my life. Amen. The next thing John is saying here, that we beheld his glory. What is glory? A lot of times in the Bible, glory is nothing but the manifestation of God's presence that can possibly be perceived by human beings like you and I. In other words, when we saw the Word that became flesh, we saw God. He was not a teacher. He was not a prophet. He was not just some good man, but he was God in the flesh. And we saw his glory. We saw his essence. Through Jesus Christ, God gave to us as much as we could contain of his divine nature. And it's just enough for us to come in contact with God. And so I want to ask you today, some of you wondering, well, in my circumstances, where is God? Where can I look for him? Look at Jesus. The Word became flesh. Some of you wonder, well, does God care about me? What about my needs? I'm jobless. I have a family that I need to feed. I don't know what your circumstances are. Some of you dealing maybe with depression or whatever the case is. And you're wondering, like, where is God? Can he hear me? Look at Jesus. Look no further. He's right there. He's in the person of Jesus Christ. Amen? Some of you think like, man, But I'm too sinful. Dre, you don't understand. You don't even understand what's going on in my mind. You don't even know what I did this week. And I'm so ashamed of it now. God can't possibly accept me. Look at Jesus. He came to save you. He came to set you free. Amen. And so, I just want to encourage you that as we enter in this holiday season, think about, forget about December 25th, forget about January 7th, forget about everything, like all these religious attributes. But meditate on this. The Word became flesh and made His dwelling among us. The reason why I have hope is because the Word became flesh. The reason why I can be forgiven is because the Word became flesh. The reason why I have eternal life. The reason why I have the peace of mind. The reason why I can overcome sin in my life is because the Word became flesh. The reason why God is able to hear me every time I pray to Him is because the Word became flesh. And that's what we're celebrating. That's what we're remembering. Never lose sight of that. This is the greatest event in human history. Amen. And I just want to end by praying with you guys. Let's go before the Lord. Just close your eyes, bow your heads. If you have any special needs, if you feel like you're too far from God, the Word became flesh. Come to Him right now, and you can make it right. Right here, right now. And if you need somebody to pray with you, please come down here. We'll be happy to do that. Whether you need to accept Jesus as your Savior, or you're a backslidden Christian, or you just have other needs of anything, the Word became flesh. And because of Jesus, when we pray, God hears us. Come, whatever your needs are. Father, we just thank you so much for the fact that you chose to humble yourself and come to us. Father, we thank you for the fact that you just accept us as we are, but you love us too much to leave us the way we are. And Lord, I pray for each and every person today that you would reveal yourself to them. You would reveal yourself to them as the Savior who came in the flesh, the came from the spiritual world, innocent, perfect, without sin. And you chose to put your hands into dirt and deal with our problems and deal with our situations. And not only that, but you're also able to help us overcome all those things. We trust you, Lord. We thank you. We love you, Lord. I pray for every person who is having needs this Christmas, Lord, that you make this season special for them. And not only this season, because it will be over before you even know it, but the rest of their lives, Lord. I pray for those who came here depressed and down and thinking that I'm up to no good. I just pray that you reach down to them and touch them. Lord, that we be all through the spiritual eyes be able to behold your glory. The glory of the one and only who came from the Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And we pray in your precious name. Amen. Thank you very much. If anybody still needs prayer, please come down. And we're just going to proceed. We got a few more things in the church service. And Atalene.
Amen. God is good. Thank you, Dre. Thank you for a wonderful message. Yes, before we end our service, we would like to ask if there's anyone among you who is first-time visitors in ICA. May we kindly ask to please stand up? We would like to greet you with a warmest greeting from the ICA family. So anymore, yes, please, keep on standing up. Please, we want to know which country you come from. So, okay, may we start with the beautiful lady in front. So, ma'am? Pakistan! Wow! God bless Pakistan! Welcome to ICA and God bless you, sister. Okay, and yes, ma'am? Kenya! Woo, Kenya! Okay, the lady in white? Filipinas! God bless Philippines. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. Please. Don't be shy. We will not bite you. Okay. Ma'am, which country you come from? Philippines! Nagagalak po kami makasama kayo sa araw na ito. And the last one, yes. Philippines! Wow! God bless Philippines. So the ushers will give you some information card. Please fill it up with your contact number, email address, and our beloved pastors would love to send you our loves and thoughts, you know. So may we again please kindly stand up again. I'm sorry. Please remain standing, those who are first-time visitors. Yeah. Yeah. And you know, we wanted to see you Sunday after Sunday, and we wanted you to experience the love and grace and mercy of God. So I say, family, could you please extend up your hands and let's pray for them, okay? Father, thank you so much to God, Lord, for this wonderful women and men of God, God. Lord, we pray, Father, in Jesus' mighty name that you bless them. Keep them safe at all times, O God, Lord. Protect them, O God, Lord. And may they know and may come to know the knowledge, the grace, and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ, O God. Lord, bless their hearts, O God, Lord, that if they keep coming back on the church, O God, Lord, not because we wanted them, Lord, to convert, but rather, O God, because your power will transform their lives and will bless them in Jesus' mighty name. We pray. Thank you. Amen. Amen.
Any first time from Ghana? From Nigeria? A good afternoon, church. For today's announcement, our English service will almost done. And after this, we have a Russian service that will start at 12:30. And after the Russian service, we're going to have our special celebration, the Christmas. They're so excited. The Filipino Fellowship are going to have our Christmas celebration after the Russian service. It will start at 2 o'clock. So from 2 to 4, we're inviting you to join us as we celebrate Christmas. Amen. And after this service, we have the bread and butter class. They are now studying in 1 Timothy chapter 4. Chapter 4, right, Dre? Yeah, 1 Timothy chapter 4. And on December 25, the ICA, we're going to celebrate our Christmas party. So we have these flyers, our invitation flyers for Christmas. All you need is love. So you can grab a copy from this and you can invite your friends and give it out for your friends, employers, and workmates, flatmates, our classmates. Anyone who wants to celebrate Christmas. And we also have this card, our the International Christian Assembly card, where the address in it is here, the address in Russian and in English, I think. Yeah, no Filipino. Next time we can request. And that's all for today. Can I have Dr. Len?
Okay, I thought that it should be Tagalog. But Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, I believe this is the last but one thing on the on today's agenda, and we're doing fine schedule-wise, but I'm here to present one more thing that I believe became a part of our ICA ministry. And namely, this is all about orphanages. And if you can throw in the slides onto the... Yes, here. Oh, and yesterday we had this wonderful candlelight service at Dom Turista. And quite a few people showed up, but that was a beautiful concert. And the doctor did a great job. Presenting their case and just really serving. And I'm really excited that they... Okay, let's go back. And I'm really excited that they start their service as doctors by serving other people. And there are more opportunities there as well. And at our international school, we started a so-called... we'll get there. We started the Shoebox Project. And I would say that we kind of inherited this project from a guy who used to be the son, and who is the son, of one of our staff members. Somehow the church walked out of this project for a good reason, but our international school stayed, and then the International Christian Assembly joined in. And now, so we just gather funds, we gather presents, and these are the presents that we take to the kids. And first we go to Rochelle. This is a center where they have a temporary residence for the kids who stay there for 3 or 4 months. And you know, many of them, they have fathers and mothers. But those fathers and mothers, they're just deprived of the parental rights. And by the way, we have a visitor from Pakistan today. This young man, he's our school graduate, he's from Pakistan. And he is now serving in the military. His father was a military attaché here in Moscow. And we do a little celebration there. You know, I saw myself being a Santa Claus. This is the first time. I didn't even know that I did that. But again, these are the kids. These are the kids who just transfer through those places. And of course, they're so excited about gifts. And that's what we believe we can just bring some difference to them. Okay, this is my son, Vitaly. He was that tall 2 years ago. Now he's taller than me. But you know, the ministry is also growing, which is very exciting. And there's a story about these two guys, Luba and Justin. They went together to an orphanage to serve. You know what happened next? They got married. Okay, I want you to understand, going to an orphanage is not a marriage proposal, all right? But things happen. Things happen, and God sometimes blesses you in a very unusual way when you serve in an unusual way too. So we need to remember to do good, because that's what God expects us to do. That's what pleases God. And then just another orphanage, just a few more pictures. Shatalova, this is Smolensk region, 570 kilometers from Moscow. It's a long way out, but we wanted just to go there as well and serve the kids. This lady, in the first time I came there, she just met us and she said, "Who are you?" We said, "Oh, you know, we're a group of ICA people and International School of Tomorrow people. We're here with the gifts." Nice. You should have told us ahead of time, because we came about 20 people and they had to feed us, accommodate us. Actually, we were in the wrong. We didn't give them a warning, but now they're so dear to us. They are our dear friends. Over 10 years, we're going to them. They feed us, they accommodate us, and these are the kids in this other orphanage. These are the kids and these are people who go there, and this is a real, real blessing that that so many people go. These are people, you know, just from ICA. If you look at them, you can recognize some of them. And this is really... Oh, yeah, somebody just pointing to a person, right, to Emma. And this is, again, Vitaly just a few years ago. First time he came there, you know what happened? He all of a sudden, in the middle of our fellowship, he runs away. And I find him in about an hour, he's in the corner and he's crying. It was too overwhelming for him. Too overwhelming. All those kids without mothers and fathers, or with fathers and mothers who are either drunkards or drug addicts or even criminals. And by the way, you want to hear about forgive your enemies, you want to hear about forgiveness, go to this orphanage. Find a girl whose father killed her mother in front of her. He was in prison. And when we talked to her, she said, you know what? Yes, father did the wrong thing, but really I believe that God forgave him and I forgave him too. You talk about forgiveness, you go to these orphanages, you find forgiveness there. And again, they throw a concert for us, and so doing a great thing, and then we share with them our international spirit, our spirit of Jesus Christ. We share with them the Christmas story as well. So, and you know, they know about Jesus Christ. They know about Jesus Christ, but it's important for them just to know also that God loves them, that we are there because we care. And we come this way every year, and then they just, instead of the tattoos, they put down Savior Jesus in a marker. But that's important that they understand this. And of course, time of fellowship and a time of singing. And so all these things will be available. And so again, God wants us to show the fruit of our spirit by deeds. And this is something that we can do. And I just, right now, I'm calling you so that we'll just have a little gathering of the funds for this orphanage trip. It goes to the church. Then we will report on all the finances, on all the dime and all the rubles spent on this during this service. But this time, some of the kids are coming to Moscow for a Christmas celebration here, and they will go to a concert, and so we're gathering money also for their trip, for the bus, and for the gifts. So God bless you as you give now. And since we don't have anybody to sing, okay, I'll sing, okay. To three. One, two, three, yeah.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. Okay. I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
God bless you as you give.
Okay, well, sorry guys, we had a little negotiation going on. I just want to clarify something. There's one more way you guys can participate in it. If you have any clothes for children or shoes, say like from like 7-year-olds, right? From 7 to like 18. Yeah, you can bring it next Sunday here to the church. We'll sort it out and we'll make sure it goes to them. But, you know, if you have, like, kids' shoes and stuff, Well, make sure they knew, okay, and in a decent shape. You know, make sure it's something that you would get for your children.
And I would say thank you to all of you who already donated, because the orphanage in Rochelle, they actually also run the service of providing clothes for other orphanages and homeless people. And some of you brought such wonderful lady shoes that I want to wear them. They're so beautiful. So thank you very much. You're doing a great job.
I don't know if I want to see that, but anyway, let's all stand. Let's go before the Lord one more time. Father, we thank you. We thank you for your presence here. We thank you for your word. We thank you for the opportunity to serve others, Lord. We ask you that you speak to our hearts and you will just help us to be useful in your kingdom, not only by following you in our personal lives and making decisions according to your word and stuff, but also help us to serve people in a practical way, whether through donating clothes or finances or helping somebody in any kind of way. We just ask you to give us wisdom and give us the desire to do it. Lord, I ask you for each and every person that you be with them as they leave this place, and that we will just continue following you throughout the week, Lord. Help us to draw nearer to you. Lord, we ask you that you just be with us, Lord. Give us favor in everything we're doing, Lord, and give us clear direction. And Lord, I ask you that you would also be with Pastor John as he's traveling right now. Lord, that you protect him, Lord, that you will give him favor, Lord. You strengthen the family as they're mourning over there. Lord, and bring him back safely in Jesus' name, Lord. And also bring us back here next Sunday for the celebration of your birth in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you very much. Shake hands with each other. Give each other a hug. Get some tea, coffee. Enjoy yourselves.
Deeper, deeper.